With Tizen, it's easy to learn how to make web apps because they follow HTML5 standards. Hi everyone, Michael here from Samsung Developers. Today we'll be exploring the self-camera sample which uses media streams and how it works. It comes with a timer and the way to preview the shots taken. Let's begin with a little background on what makes our app work. The Media Capture and Streams Working Draft from the W3C or World Wide Web Consortium defines the API that allows access to the device's camera and microphone. Since this started with PCs, the front camera is usually captured. As Tizen offers a platform that conforms to the latest web standards, you can expect this to be implemented and ready for use with Tizen web apps. As a good example of this, we're using the self-camera sample. The main code we'll need to make our self-camera work is navigator.getUserMedia. This comes from the media capture and streams mentioned earlier. Alongside this is other functions that help initialize the page and do countdowns for us. We'll also have code that will help in performing input and output operations. Before we discuss how all of these are used in the code, let's get familiar with a few requirements. To develop the app, you'll need the latest Tizen SDK. For our development, we'll need Tizen 2.3.1 and above. Our app is already available as a sample app inside the Tizen IDE, so you can follow along. If you'd like to test out the app, having a real device like the Samsung Z1 would be great since it needs a camera. If you don't have one, you can go to developer.samsung.com and sign up for the remote test lab. For privileges in config.xml, you'll need a few of them. Application.launch, since the app will be calling for the system's image viewer. Filesystem.read and write, as it will be having input and output operations. Content read and write, because it will need to read and write media content information. Lastly, media capture, as this will allow access to the device's camera stream. With these requirements explained, it's time to look at the code. Let's start with our index.html. We have 6 major divs that are visible to the user: the camera itself, the countdown timer, timer buttons, thumbnail, shutter container, and the bar at the bottom. There's also one more div for the failure, which is only displayed if there's a problem. All these divs are styled by style.css found inside the CSS folder. For the actions, we have main.js and app.systemio.js. Just before we dive into main.js, let's have a peek at what System.io helps us with. System.io is a class that takes care of all the input and output that our app has to deal with. There are functions for creating, writing, and saving content to files, opening locations, listing files, getting path data, checking if a file exists, deleting nodes, files, and directories. It brings the native JavaScript file management functions together and implements them as needed by the self-camera. Now that we know what's inside System.io, let's explore main.js. Main.js contains a class called self-camera with its own constructor. When the page is loaded, it calls on the init function, which starts by checking the saved directory if it's valid. If it is, then it instantiates a new object of System.io. The previous photo taken is loaded from storage. Then the preview starts. The preview will take the stream from the front camera using the navigator.getUserMedia function we mentioned earlier. A video element is created to hold the live stream from the front camera. The preview places the stream in the video element. Success and error events during video capture are then bound. Once the preview is in place and streaming, other events are then bound for mouse down, mouse up, touch start, and touch end. There's also a checker for an event when the back key is pressed. A launch preview event is also bound, so when the user touches the thumbnail, the self-camera app will call the system's image viewer and load the appropriate images. Most importantly, the shutters event is bound. Once the shutter is pressed, a countdown starts, and when the timeout is reached, the current state of the canvas is saved. This saved image is then written and saved as an image file in the device. That explains the code of our app. Let's have a quick demo of it. Here you see our app in action. We're using a live device to test it out. There are timer settings at the top which we can set. If we take a photo, the thumbnail gets populated with the most recent photo taken. Tapping on our thumbnail, the system's image viewer is launched with the right image. The image is really saved onto our device, and we can even view it using the gallery. That wraps up our quick demo. Time for a summary. HTML5 stands at the very core of Tizen web apps. Media capture provides access to the camera and microphone stream of the device. A number of privileges are needed in our app today. Besides media capture, you'll also need a few more for reading and writing data. That's it for our episode today on the self camera. We hope it helped show how Tizen is very much in tune with industry standards to allow quick development of apps. The sample app is available to recreate in the latest release of the Tizen SDK 2.3.1. Be sure to check out the upcoming Tizen 2.4 SDK to stay ahead with the latest trends on developing for Tizen. Please click like and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel to watch out for more news and tips on developing for Tizen 2.4 beta. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.